beings were there who wore a human form. Yet they were not human. In words, nature was preparing a biological form for the human to appear. She was preparing a biological form until now. Actually, it's a very long and very tiresome and very difficult kind of a process to bring out something of that sort out of nothing. Life has entered into matter, there is no life, nothing, 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 and from that to build up gradually, 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 all these million forms of life is a gigantic work, most unimaginable, most astounding also, that there was nothing and she has built so many forms in the material creation, you see. Matter is the base and she is exploiting matter, the base, and expressing the joys of life in various forms, endless forms actually. And she has now come to the point where a human form may appear, though not a human being. Human form would mean genus pan, pan, genus pan, P-A-N, genus pan. Human proper is genus homo. We belong to a genus homo, but at this stage he is genus pan, P-A-N, you see, at this point, you see. So, in the words, there is a kind of a driving objective also in life's creating forms. She is not creating this form just for the sake of joy, create and enjoy. She is also having some kind of an objective in creating all the created form, leading to something more and more, something more and more expression in the process of evolution. So there is a kind of a hidden logic, a mechanism, a design in all these movements of life. Beings were there who wore a human form, absorbed, they lived in the passion of the scene. Well, it is the life force alone, the passion of the scene. They lived only in the passion of the scene, means in the life force alone, what life wants, you see. But knew not who they were or why they lived. A chimpanzee, bonbon, orangutan, all these big animals are there. They are almost like human in a certain sense. They are there, but they don't know why they are there, what for they are there. They have no idea at all. They still belong to genus Pan, P-A-N. Although chimps are a highly developed creature who can make instruments, he is the only creature in the animal world who can make his own instruments, tools. That is the most important thing. And the discovery of the chimps making tools was made as late as in 1960 by Jane Goodall, you see, in England. She discovered that chimps can make their own tools, you see. I don't know why she had taken such a long, long time to understand that chimps can make tools, can make instruments, you see. Beings were there who wore a human form, absorbed, lived in the passion of the scene, in the life force, in the expression of life, in the dynamism, in the push, in the thrill of life, but knew not who they were or why they lived. Life had for them no aim save nature's joy. Well, for the sake of joy alone, nature is multiplying herself in various forms, just for the sake of joy of nature. And the stimulus of delight of outer thing, well, the little aim, objective is the stimulus. Matter which is insensitive, which is not responding to anything at all, cannot respond. In that, she is able to produce some kind of a sensation. That is the aim, that is the delight of outer things, you see. They worked for the body's wants. They craved no more. Well, body's wants, well, you have to maintain yourself and you do whatever you want to do. Eat animals, eat fruit, eat grass, whatever you like, you see. They have to keep on eating. But the body's want, they craved no more. Content to breathe, to feel, to sense, to act. Identify the spirit's outward shell. Well, that is what, that kind of a life is there of a human form, you see. Content, I am. To breathe, I am. To feel, I am. To sense, I am. To act, and I am, you see. Perfectly iambic line, pentameter, you see. Content, to breathe, to feel, to sense, to act. It really comes like a beat, 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 you see, you see. Identify to the spirit's outward shell. In other words, the spirit's inner core has something else, so to say, in his mind, but they are not aware of it. They are not aware of it. The way spectator watching from that depth, who is there within that spectator, fix not his inward eye apart himself in these animals. He is not really seeing within, he is only seeing the outward need for survival, need for existence, need to be. But I don't know whether these animals, they also have a kind of a knowledge that there is going to be death. That there is going to be death. I don't know.
I don't think they are
even not conscious from themselves. No, but some sort of an instinctive feeling, life instinct. There is some life instinct. See, a dog, does he know that, well, he will live for 15 years, 16 years, 20 years, and then ultimately it has to die?
The animals don't have this.
I don't know that they have that instinct, that their lifespan is a relatively short one. A really short one. Because, see, had that feeling been there, that there is a relatively short span of life for them, it is an already advanced kind of an instinct, which would also mean that they might start taking measures if it can be prevented, if it can be elongated, if it can be extended. See, if that instinct is there, I am going to die tomorrow, then I will take certain measures to see if it can be prolonged, you see. It can be prolonged. So that is not there at all, you see. So I don't think that way they have a native instinct of the short span of their life, you see. The way spectator watching from their depths fix not his inward eye upon himself, now turn to find the author of the plot. He saw the drama. He saw the drama only and the stage. Well, coming and going, passing show of life and the nature, the scenery, whatever is there on that. That is the stage of him. The forest, the green land, whatever it is, all the water in which they live, you see. There was no brooding stress of deeper sin. It is not there, it is absent. Although they are having a sort of a human form, that sense, deeper sense is missing still, you see. The burden of reflection was not borne. Mind looked on nature with unknowing eyes. Well, they have a kind of a vital mind, pranic mind, and with that mind they are looking upon nature with eyes that do not know things, you see. Adored her bones. Her nature, adored her bone, they adored her bone and feared her monstrous strokes. So that the kind of deeper sense is there within, you see. It pondered not on the magic of her laws. What is the magic of her laws? Breathing, survival, the instinct to grow, the expand, the instinct to expand. That is her magic law. Law of life is to expand, to grow, to express herself in various ways. That is the law of life, you see. It thirsts not for the secret well. It thirsts not for the secret wells of truth. Well, so there are deeper truths already. It has never that idea at all that it can be, because that inner eye has not told. Made a register of crowding facts and strong sensations on a vivid thread, on a vivid sensation of vivid thread. It hunted and it fled and sniffed the winds. Well, that is what the animals do. It hunts, of course. It flies, it flees, moves fast, sniffed the wind, or slows inert in sunshine and soft air. Well, enjoying nature in its own ways, it sought the engrossing contacts of the world, but only to feed the surface sun with bliss. All that for what? You are sitting under the sunshine, you are sitting in the sun, enjoying the sunshine. Well, the animal is definitely enjoying the sunshine, you see. It is not sitting there solely. That sensation is there. It sought the engrossing context of the world, you see, relationship. Actually, when an animal comes in contact with the man, human being, then it has a different sensation altogether. A street dog behaves differently than a dog which is kept in the house as a pet, you see. The human association brings out something of the deeper nature of the dog, of the pet, you see, in that way. It sought the engrossing contacts of the world, but only to feed the surface and with bliss. Well, this felt lies quiver in the outward touch. They could not feel behind the touch. The soul not behind, they could not feel behind the touch, the soul. Well, the sensation is there, but they are not feeling that there is something deeper within them. The soul, the psychic element is present. They don't have that. To guard their form or self from nature's harm, to enjoy and to survive. To guard their form or self from nature's harm, to enjoy and to survive, was all their care. Well, that is what the animals do. See, the herd of elephants, the herd of the pack of lions, or whatever it is, see, they live together for what? To enjoy and to survive. That is all the concern, all the while, you see. Too narrow horizon of their days was filled with things and creatures that could help and hurt. With things and creatures that could help and hurt. The world's values hung upon their little self. For them, that little self which is there, you see, on that. Well, to survive, to live, to be there, under whatever circumstances be there, that is the only instinct. Isolated, cramped in the vast unknown. Crammed in the vast unknown. Yeah, you have got the open field completely, but an animal is kind of crammed in its own small little sensations, in its own small ways of doing things. Isolated, crammed in the vast unknown to save their small lives from surrounding death. To save their small lives from surrounding death. They made a tiny circle of defense. Again, the sea is a huge universe. They preyed upon, what is the siege they are making? Prey upon the world and become the world's prey. They preyed upon the world and were its prey. Eat and get eaten. Eat, eaten. That is the law, that is what it is. And against that, well, they are living in that, you see. So all their defense is for that purpose. But never dream to conquer and be free. That little element is there in man, even in the crudest man, that element, to dream and to conquer and be free. that element is there, already present in man. Even the smallest means not very developed creatures, man, you see. They preyed upon the world, and world is prey. Well, this is the law of survival of the fittest also. The eater eating is eaten. Well, that is what the Upanishads say, they have been saying. The eater eating is eaten, you see. Prey and get preyed, you see. A tiger will eat a deer. So the deer is the prey for the tiger. And what does the deer eat? The deer does not live on, it lives on grass, on vegetables, you see, on vegetarian things only, you see. So the survival level also becomes different altogether, you see. But never dream to conquer and be free. See, even in the world of birds, in the kingdom of the birds, I don't know whether really a big bird will eat a small bird. Although a crow might eat a small sparrow. A crow does that thing. A crow will eat a small sparrow, you see. But generally, a bird does not eat another bird.
Yes, because they eat. Of course.
They eat? Big bird will eat small bird?
They eat birds, of course. They eat. Many predator birds, and they eat other birds.